Hey, check this out, you guys. Got Tyson here. We're here just talking, and he has not yet got the words for Maluma in The Weeknd's, you know, remix of Hawaii. And he knew of the song, and he knows of Maluma. You know, the guy's a star everywhere he goes. But I got to get Tyson's reaction to this because there's very few people who I think will appreciate this. Now, Tyson. I'm over here. Look, knocking over lights. I'm over here about to, like, I'm jamming this for, you know, a few months since it came out. Kids are like, what are we listening to? And I'm like, man, a hit. And then when he put The Weeknd on it, they listened to it just a little more, right? But right. I said, hold on, let me like break down the lyrics to them with the folks who break down lyrics online. And I'm like, I'm getting ready to dance with this, with Tina, and, you know, get our Kizomu on, on, where we're getting real close. And then I said, let me break this down because, you know, Spanish music, it really can go back into like the love, amore, you know, they love hard still. Mm-hmm. Hard to find that in R&B if, you know, the king of R&B now, all it is bedroom, you know, get you in the bedroom, boom, boom. And it's so right. much more to this thing than that, if you're a grown man. So I remember being a kid and it being all about that, you know, and right. I know you know about that. So I'm going to just, So I'm going to just get your reaction. And, you know, I wish you could stop and start it as we go. But just tell me if you need me to, you know, replay that back. Here we go. YouTube, don't demonetize it. We'll get to the lyrics. All right, hold on. I gotta stop it so you can read it. I don't want you to just rush through. Okay. So you're reading this, right?
Yeah.
This is a love song. So I'm gonna let it play. Tell me I can let it play.
Yeah, you can let it ride. You can let it ride.
Okay. Should I let it ride through the whole thing and go back?
Yeah. We could just let it go and I'll kind of speed read it and then we'll get the reactions.
Okay, because there's no problem. You know, the more we stop it, the more YouTube won't flag it. So
I mean, if you want to pause period, however you want to make it roll, I'm here for it.
Okay. So we know this song is, you know, he's trying to get the girl back, whatnot. Okay, right. Cool. We get it.
Right. And he, you know, he's like, I get it. Cause you off with another dude. Cause I don't want to settle down. I don't want to be married. He's not saying he don't want to be with her, but he's saying, I don't want to get married. Up. So we get that.
Here we go. And you know what, Tyson, you know what we may do? Cause I can edit this. I'm going to call you on the phone. Because I just got right then when you said, right, it reverbed. I can't have your reaction go out. So if you mute yourself, then we'll just use the audio from the phone.
Okay.
Wait, will that work?
I think I can still use it as a hotspot.
Okay. And are you, I don't know if you're recording on your end. In case it sounds different on your end, feel free.
Okay. Then yeah, let me hit the record on that.
Yeah. And because I can't have it be like, what the heck y'all talking about?
All right, let's see if it'll still work.
If it doesn't, I mean, I got my mic here, so it should capture if I have everything on speaker, everything you're saying.
Okay.
So, all right. So you guys, we're going to play this thing. And so, you know, now he's your heaven. You got all that. Here we go.
Lying to yourself and him to make me jealous.
This is The Weeknd's part.
You put on such a neck when you're sleeping together.
And I think The Weeknd killed this.
I said I don't want men run. I don't want men hurt. I'd rather go out on the bay. Cause at least I know that it's not temporary. And at least we'll share something that's me. I can tell that you're just trying to
be. I gotta pause it there, Tyson. Because that's your part right there. Yeah. That's your part. You can feel that.
This right here is forever.
Yeah. That's where Tyson and I differ, but that's okay. That's where he's comfortable. And a lot of y'all would be like, I'd rather go have fun a baby because the woman is going to, you know, flip on me, whatnot. You know, I got a session for y'all if you want to know how to, you know, have that not happen. You got to book it, though.
I know how to make them not flip, but sometimes it's like, hey, maybe I need a step up.
Definitely. Definitely. So I think The Weeknd really, you know, he killed this for a big population that like, hey, this marriage thing is so much business. But this song with Maluma alone just gets deeper. And Weeknd, he just kind of added on pretty much, you know, here we go. Okay, can you see that?
Yep.
And you might not have a care in the world. In Hawaii on vacation, right. Congrats to the Instagram, it's cute, but I see what you're doing,
right?
Bruh, what's your thoughts on that?
So, this makes me think of Big Sean's I Don't F With You,
yeah.
I mean, you posted up, you're taking a pic, posting it up, you're making me sick. No.
I see the game, even though...
I see you doing this for me, trying to get my attention real quick, but I know the real truth behind it.
Here we go. He's saying, go ahead and lie to the followers.
Do it. You already was doing it anyway.
Bruh, when I saw this, I said, hold on. I know Tyson. There's only a few people who will get this. But, dude, she's having a vacation. She's chilling. You watching her Instagram and you make a song, like, could you imagine you on, you know, you've had those situations where women see you doing well and then they have to hit you up on social media. So I gotta play this. Hey, hold on. You laugh. You what's your thought? Cause you heard what I think you heard what I heard.
Right. Pretty much. Everybody else, but you know what it is. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, sometimes you just have that connection with someone, right? And if for some reason it can't work out, maybe you messed up, they messed up, signals got crossed, whatever the case is. But the love doesn't go away. The feeling, you're like, I know I connect with that person. It doesn't go away, but you have to pretend that it goes away, because otherwise that'll destroy your new relationship, right? So he's like, I see that that's what you're doing, and you're doing it well. That's LL to say. You know,
But you know, I appreciate Spanish music because he went old school when somebody done moved on, like Lenny Williams type stuff. And, you know, you moved on, but I moved on, whatever. But he said, you're not happy.
Right. but is you happy?
Yeah.
That's old. I got one question for you. Is you happy?
And Tyson, it's been a minute, right, for me having to be on the dating scene. I mean, man, a minute, a decade. But the fact that you know, that line used to work when someone would say, oh, but I got a boyfriend, or I got, but you say, but are you happy? How many times has that worked?
Every time. I mean, smell the unhappiness sometimes. You feel the missing component of their life. And you like, I can feel that. I can handle that all day. And so you just, when you ask it and they pause, the other part is they pause and then they'll try to be like, well, yeah, I'm happy. No, you took a little bit too long to think about that. You know what I mean? That means to me either you never thought about your happiness before, or you've never truly questioned it. Either way, why are you there if you can't have that complete answer? And that doesn't mean that you have to like it all the time. That's not what we're talking about. But we're talking about, do you still feel like you'll come out on the other end happy? And when people start to doubt that, that's where the game just slides in and takes the victim.
Because a real happy woman, she won't even let you get that far.
Right. She'd be like, hey, why are you asking me about my happiness? You don't get out of here. Like, I got a bath test.
Yeah.
What that got to do with this? Now we were just both talking about things we smoked to cheat on.
here we go. You know, he keeps going on with the same game, but I felt this song so much before even going through all the lyrics. I feel it. Bruh, he said you can't buy it, but I see you're doing well. And he's really saying you're really lacking nothing. Like, translation is one of those things, right? But he's saying you're not lacking anything in life. You're happy, but still, I'm gonna hit you up and just, you know, put my last shot.
Right. Exactly. And that's that gap. You don't have to be lacking anything in order to not get the things that money can't handle.
Yeah, I just want to know. I really want to know the backstory. I guess we got to ask Maluma, like, what's the backstory on it? Because who, you know, he messed up. I just know he messed up. All right, I'm going to let it continue. So that's the song. What are your thoughts?
I mean, I feel like the theme's carrying through. It's just reconnected to that. It really, honestly, if we broke it down, it sounds like the mess up in the relationship was him not wanting to take it as seriously as she did. And she was like, well, if you can't meet me at marriage, then I'm going to dip out. And that's her choice, right? That's fair. That's a fair choice if you don't connect on that. But realize that if marriage is the end result, the journey matters just as much. So you may get the marriage and the look that you want over here, but if you're still empty on everything else, you start to have to look at it and say, is it really worth it?
And just to be clear, because I could hear some folks who, you know, been bumping this for a while, they've done their reaction videos. In the first song, the remix talks about marriage with The Weeknd. The first song, right, he's basically just saying, you know, what you saw, and they just kind of added The Weeknd. So someone will say, oh, no, there was no marriage mentioned in the first one. That's not what he meant.
But I think this may give more context to the first one, because before, you didn't have anything to go off other than a dude scrolling through the gram just going, I know she missed me. I know I'm the one she really wants. That could be just him trying to make himself feel better. This one right here gives more of a context and a backstory saying, I didn't want marriage. And that's where we fell apart. And The Weeknd reiterates, like, man, I just don't want marriage. Like, that's the reason. That's the breakdown in our relationship. And I think that that's more plausible than saying, well, no, there wasn't a mention of it. Well, there wasn't a mention of anything. So why do we even think that he messed up, or what, or how do we know what he messed up on?
So this is what
we got some clues here.
This is what I need from, you know, everybody out there. I need to hear the female version to, you know, how that used to be real hot. And I think, you know, bring the female remix, kind of like Girls Need Love Too. And I know, what is it? Vito did, you know, the remix. And I love that remix that he did. Shout out to him. I wish he'd check his emails because I'd love to talk to him. And also we need the K-pop version. K-pop needs to jump on this because, you know, because they sing about love still in that traditional sense, where it's kind of hard to have, you could think of whoever. They don't really, you know, Drake could knock this out, you know, on the English side, but we already got The Weeknd. But I need to see that international appeal, the Afrobeat possibly. Afrobeat will take it to a whole different thing, and then do that female version of that where everyone's just doing their version of song. That's what I need out there.
He said, I need to hear it.
I need to hear it because people, everybody is crazy, and everyone thinks, oh man, I got to get out this relationship. Like there's a better one for you. Get you in the best relationship that if it's lasted a year, you're probably in the best relationship here for over 30 that you're going to be in. Now, if you're 20, hey, hop, skip, and jump. But you dealt with this for a year, 2 years. You might as well stick with it or it's going to cost you.
Right.
Nah, that I had to get you. I had to get your, you know, your intake on that. People, like, share, subscribe, all that. Tyson's info will be in there. He'll tell you about his new company. He'll tell you about, you know, everything he has going on. We're gonna go offline where we can rap. You might see it, you might not, but be blessed. Yeah, bruh, that I thought that was I just thought that was, you know, that was, I said, Tyson will feel this one, you know. And I wasn't even thinking about the marriage part, but I'm just like, this dude is really, oh, this dude.
You got the mic coming at you.
Yeah.
I said, this. I have those lights, actually.
Which ones?
The stick ones.
Okay. You know, they're cool for what they are, but they're not like the best. Like, I got these two on both sides, right? And even during the day, I don't, I have a light on my camera as well. I have a light on my camera, like, yeah, hella, I need hella light. Like, I don't know, my face becomes a shadow. So So yeah, man, that's that's the game. But I said this is the asshole anthem. Somebody's on vacation, and
rain on the parade real quick
all day long. And because I've had that in the past, and hey, I see that you know you're happily married with kids and being a good father. Can I? Yeah. Remember when, like, if you don't get out of this, DM or whatever, you know, I got the same phone from when I was in high school.
Right.
Yeah, but that's the game.